Are you looking for a gluten-free chapati option? Well, we have many. Ragi roti, jowar roti, and this besan ki roti or chapati or fulka. So for this easy recipe of besan roti, we need to heat 1/4 cup of water. Let it come to a rolling boil. And if you want to add oil, you can add 1/2 cup of besan when water starts boiling. And at this stage, turn off the flame. Mix with a spoon and cover for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you may use wet hands. You need to use wet hands to gather the dough. And if it looks dry, you can add 1 tablespoon extra of water at this stage. And knead it for at least 2 to 3 minutes. It should be a semi-soft dough, not too soft and not too hard. If at this stage it feels hard, you can add 1 tablespoon of water. Now rest the dough for 10 minutes and after 10 minutes it is ready to make besan, chapati or fulka. Now the dough should be easy to roll. If it feels tight, knead with 1 tablespoon more of water. But remember not to make it too soft. Otherwise it will continue to stick to the belan. Now you can use any utensil to cut a round shape if you want it round. Now place on the tawa and cook on the lowest flame at this stage. And after a couple of seconds, flip. And now at this stage, you can turn the heat to high. And look how it puffs up. It puffs up, it's very soft. We'll do another one. Gluten-free chapatis tend to break, but these do not. If you want to add 1 teaspoon of oil to the dough, you can add to make these even softer, but these are really very soft and you won't feel as if you are not eating atta roti. Look, these puff up so well, and this was not I chose to keep it as is. I did not make it a circular one, but it's okay. I just wanted to show you how all of my rotis puffed up. Look, these are besan ki roti, chapati and fulka. I'll come up with the millet roti chapati soon. So look, and I enjoyed it with soya chili, which uses no vinegar and no soya sauce as well. I'll be sharing the recipe. If you want to learn any other gluten-free chapati, please write to me in comments. And please do not forget to share what is your favorite gluten-free chapati. I'll be waiting for your comments. I hope you like this recipe. If you do, please like, share and subscribe.